Her Royal Highness is greeted by the Lord Lieutenant of Hampshire. The second in command of the mounted escort is Sergeant Allchurch. The mounted escort is commanded by Captain Simon Ledger. Her Royal Highness is accompanied by the Colonel of the Regiment, Major General Stuart Watson, and the Commanding Officer, Lieutenant Colonel Edward York. The combined bands of the 30th 18th Royal Hussars and the South Nottinghamshire Hussars Yeomanry are commanded by W1 Chatburn. The number one guard is commanded by Major Michael Brooke, who commands B Squadron of the regiment. Guard is commanded by Major Martin Kolachiki, who as Gideon officer has been responsible for most of the arrangements for this parade. Thank you. Number 3 Guard is commanded by Major Edward Knoll, who is Headquarters Squadron Leader. The Number 4 Guard is commanded by Major Andrew Stewart, who commands D Squadron. The new guidon is taken by Major Ray Lang, who is now the quartermaster. As a young soldier, Major Lang was present at the 1961 parade to present the old guidon.
We ask you to bid God's blessing on this guidon.
O Lord our God, who from thy throne beholdest all the kingdoms of the earth, have regard unto our land, that it may continue a place and a people to serve thee to the end of time. Guide the government of this great commonwealth, and grant that all those who live beneath our flag may be mindful of that pre-told cross, that they may work for the good of others, according to the example of him who died in the service of men, thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, we do bless and set apart this seal, that it may be a sign of our duty towards our Queen and our country, in the sight of God. Amen. Let us pray. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Major Alan Mallinson retrieves the new guidon for the formal presentation by Her Royal Highness.
Thank you for the kind words you have spoken, and
and assure you that the regiment will continue to do its duty and strive for excellence in the years to come. May I also take this opportunity to wish you a very happy wedding anniversary. Thank you, ma'am.
Is carried by Warrant Officer 2, Norman, who is the Regimental Quartermaster Sergeant, and escorted by WO2 Hawley and Staff Sergeant Charlesworth. Her Royal Highness says farewell to her stick orderlies before being presented with a posy by the daughter of Sergeant Major Atkinson, who was also heavily involved as the Guidon Warrant Officer. At the conclusion of the parade, Her Royal Highness departed to the regimental lines. In the garden of Colonel York's home, there were formal photographs with the officers, and here, escorted by the regimental Sergeant Major, Mr. Davies, with the warrant officers and Sergeant's mess. After the photographs, Her Royal Highness visited both messes, where she graciously signed the visitors' books, before attending a formal lunch with 2,300 members of the regiment, their relatives, guests and friends. A regiment such as the 3018th Hussars is more than just a military entity. The members are all closely linked by family ties. Several serving officers and several other ranks can boast generations that have served in the regiment. Perhaps the best example is Colonel Roddy Cordy Simpson, whose great-grandfather and father both served in the regiment. After lunch, Her Royal Highness toured static displays which depicted the present role of the regiment. She also had the opportunity to meet many members of the regiment.